Hello once again, it's Mr. Pete here, and this is episode 104B, the answer portion of my What Is It Mystery Tool series. So let's dive in and see what we've got here. Thank you to Kevin Stollard, who sent all of these items to me, and we will now divulge the answers. And I did get a lot of good comments, but many people did not know what any of these items were, so let's begin. Okay, to start with, I suppose you need to be at least 70 years old to know what this little leather perverted little device is. And actually what it is, it's a corn husking pig or corn shucking. It means the same thing. This is number one. And there's even a trademark on here. It's called The Boss. And a lot of these that you run across are all stiff from sweat, or they might have mouse chewing on them. But you still see these all the time, and I think they might still make them for some third world countries. But what is the purpose? Well, corn used to be picked by hand, and men walked through the field with a wagon right alongside them, and they would pull the ear down and use this little peg here to break it off, and then without looking, they would throw the ear of corn into the wagon, and it would bounce off what they called the bounce board, I think was the name, or the bang board. Interesting item. Well, if you want to see how corn husking used to be done, there are several YouTube videos, including this one, the 1941 National Corn Husking Contest. And believe it or not, this contest was held within 15 miles of where I am standing right now in Tonica, Illinois. It was a huge event every year, and because of the war, I believe this was the last such big national contest ever put on. And of course, by then, because of the war and so on, and the way things hadn't developed, shucking corn or picking corn was a thing of the past. But they still do this in some of our little steam shows around here, and I have watched men do it. I was shocked at how many people knew what this was. Number two, I did not know, although I thought that it had something to do with springs, and several people even said it's probably a Herbrand number, what is it there, 188? And that's exactly what it is. Now, what are huck brakes? I had never heard of them, because the oldest car that I ever worked on and did a brake job on was my 51 Buick Special. And at that time, I was not aware. They weren't huck brakes. They were regular Bendix or whatever they call them. But I did not know at that time that there were special tools to help you with that, or that there were shop manuals. I was sitting out in the snow, 10 degrees, with a vice grip and a pry bar, and it slipped off the spring and hit me in the lip, and I bled like a stuck pig. I hope I never do another brake job. Let me show you a picture of what huck brakes look. Not a whole lot different, but they were used apparently in the 30s and 40s by General Motors and probably other companies as well. Well, there's a picture of a huck brake, and it looks pretty much like regular brakes, except for whatever is going on down here. Let me show you a parts breakdown. Well, I couldn't find a parts breakdown, but the one on the left is a huck brake, and the one on the right is the type that you probably recognize, a Bendix brake. And I was so happy when they came out with disc brakes. They are so much easier to work on than these old things. Well, there's item three, and I can't read the name, but this is nothing more than an uncrating tool. Years ago, so many heavy items came in a wooden crate or a partial crate with wire and wood, and this was used for opening the crate, prying, pulling nails, breaking off the wire, and so on. And there were many, many different patents on this. This is just a typical one that you might have seen years ago. Number four, I do not believe that anyone got the answer to this, and I don't blame you. I did not know what it is. It's really weird. I don't think it's ever been used because it's fresh leather. And let me show you what it is. So, it's a Le Captive Adjustable Quail Harness, and it costs $3. is for training bird dogs with live game birds under controlled conditions. Steady on point, staunch to wing and shot, prompt and tender retrieves. Use the same birds at home or afield over and over again. Well, that would be torture for the quail, wouldn't it? Bob White. And there's the instructions. And, you know, imagine holding a quail that's trying to get away and flap its wings and put it in harness. This is the craziest thing I've ever seen. But there's complete instructions on how to use this little device. $3. So you stick the bird's head right through here and harness them up. Snap that without crushing his little spine. And I believe these spikes are to keep the dog from crunching down on the quail and injuring it or even killing it. Bizarre is not the word. And finally, the extra credit was, and I've got a whole box of these. I don't think I showed them all in the other video. But these are training aids to be used in a drafting class. And I mean the older drafting class where you're using T-squares and pencils and triangles and so on. And you would make a three-view drawing or an isometric and probably dimension it using these. And these were given to me by my buddy Andy Current. Remember, he went up to Mitutoyo with me. But he said that my brother gave these to him. Now, if you have learned more modern drafting, CAD drafting, they probably did not use these, but this is a pretty awesome if the teacher put that on your desk and said, draw that up in three views. Well, that concludes this episode of What Is It? Thank you for participating. Now, at this time, do not send me any more items for What Is It? I'm winding down. I have enough in stock to do two or three more, and then I believe it will be the end of this series, because if you look at the statistics here or the analytics, how few people have watched this and very few people even participating in it. I think people have enjoyed it, but it just has run its course. There's over 105 episodes, and you can double that because there's a part A and a part B, so there's about 220 videos that I have done on this, and I think it's time to call it quits. But I am not done with other videos, so I'll see you soon in one of my regular videos. So long for now. This is Mr. Pete.